Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Wake Up Report. And I thought I would follow up my Kanye story rather quickly this time, because not 45 minutes maybe after I dropped that show, the Business Insider dropped a little bit of breaking news on their own regarding Kanye West and his campaign. Apparently, Kanye West and his campaign cohorts are going to sue Wisconsin and Ohio in a last-ditch effort to appear on the ballot. According to the Business Insider story, the Wisconsin Election Commission on August the 20th said in a 5-1 decision that West missed the deadline to file as a candidate for president by 14 seconds. Ohio Secretary of State Frank LaRose on August the 21st said that West did not meet the requirements to file as a candidate in the state, and lawyers for the rapper and fashion designer argue West didn't miss the deadline in Wisconsin and that the Ohio Secretary of State must accept West's application. Now, if it were just Wisconsin and Ohio, I don't know, maybe you'd have a case. You can wrangle over 14 seconds, but, you know, late is late. But in addition to Wisconsin and Ohio, according to the Business Insider, he has also been denied access to the ballot in Wisconsin, Ohio, Illinois, Montana, North Carolina, Texas, New Mexico, and Indiana. As if this clown has any serious chance at becoming president of the United States. The debates are in November. We know it's going to be Biden versus Trump. It's going to be Harris versus Pence. If you don't like Biden, vote for Trump. If you don't like Trump, vote for Biden. If you don't like Pence, vote for Harris. If you don't like Harris, vote for Pence. Those are the final four. This coon-ass nutbox didn't even make the Sweet 16 or the Elite Eight. Now, as far as I'm concerned, after this election is over, you know, if Donald Trump wins, he wins. He gets another 4 years, and then that's it. He's done. After this, no more celebrity presidents, no more rich people that can buy their way into elections. No more clowns and idiots, morons, goofballs, jackoffs should be able, just because they have money and they have all of the attention of the world because they're celebrities, shoot for the highest office in the land, which is President of the United States. I think that the rules need to be rewritten for presidential candidates. Probably the most important rule is that if you have not served in any form of government, I don't care what it is, you don't qualify. So you have had to at least been a city council person, an alderman, a district rep, a senator, have worked in the Senate or the House, something that has groomed you, because you have at least a basic working knowledge of government. Every once in a while, you will get an exception. You get somebody that is just, you know, they're on point, they're spot on with how they think, how they can rationalize, and how they can absorb information and be able to handle things like world economies, local issues, national issues, being able to reach across the aisle and get things done, being able to do what a president is supposed to do. But this being able to, and Bloomberg too, was the same thing with Bloomberg, was able to buy his way into an election, didn't even have to campaign, really. This clown hasn't campaigned. This clown hasn't got out on a platform to just explain himself to people, because if he did that, then we would realize he's more of an idiot than he could possibly imagine. I don't understand how the media does not go to him and say, well, I guess they have, you know, I guess, you know, it's a, you know, they ask him about, well, what about the economy? What about a foreign trade? You know, and he's like, well, if you elect me president one day, we'll fly in rocket ships and spaceships just like the Jetsons, because in an alternate universe, I am George Jetson. So no more celebrity presidents, no more presidents or no presidents that if they don't take their medication, they go all off in all kind of Cookville voyages and all that kind of mess, man. So just people who know government, people who want to work in government, is basically, would you want somebody to fly a plane that didn't go to a pilot school? I'm a garbage man, but I really would like to fly airplanes, so just give me a plane and let me fly it. So now let's get on to what I should be doing routinely, and I don't, which is answer to you guys when I put things out. You know, I thought this would be a good opportunity to take some of the comments that I got and, you know, answer those comments because, you know, whenever I do say things, I should be held accountable for what I say. So, and for the people who didn't like the show that I did, old super coon Kanye, I want to hear from you. If you thumbs down the show, that's fine with me. But I would like to hear why you thumbs down the show. I would like to hear your opinion on why you think that I was wrong, why you think I was out of the pocket. What did I say that ticked you off? You know, calling him a coon and a sellout and a whatever it is that I call him, you know, which is what I think he is. But if you don't agree with me, I want to hear from you. That's what it's for. It's open platform. We're all adults. We should be able to talk like adults. So with that being said, we'll just move on to a few comments. I don't know how somebody could say something negative about the Black Panther, you know, after my man just died, you know. But Doc Holliday says, thank God there will be no more lame ass Black Panther movies. There was only one. It wasn't that lame. That movie sucked. One of Marvel's unfortunately worst movies they made. LOL, Daredevil was ruined because of Ben Affleck. Now I'll just stop right there because obviously this guy doesn't like the Black Panther. No, Marvel's worst movie, hands down, was Captain Marvel. That piece of feminist garbage. The Black Panther, come on, dude. Now, you know, Black Panther was not that bad. Number one. Number two, there will be more Black Panther movies. Chadwick Boseman has unfortunately passed, but we're going to get another Black Panther movie. So to your disappointment, you know, we're going to get another lame-ass Black Panther movie. I hope we get 3, 4, 5, and 6 of them because you said that. But let's move on. Randy T. Foster commented on the Super Coon, story. Kanye, take your damn meds now. There aren't enough meds. There isn't enough medication on planet Earth to cure this moron. You know, the best medication for Kanye West is keep your mouth shut. That Kanye got he got an accident a while back, didn't he? Had to have his jaw wired shut. You know, should have just kept the wires on his jaw. And JH commented, could be Mr. or Miss, I don't know, but JH said, is this any different from being a Democrat Party super coon? If you can find me a Black person that has done the things that Kanye West has done and said the things that Kanye West has said and is about trying to disrupt an election with their coon foolery nonsense, I would have no choice but to agree with you. But we both know that that is not the case. I am only asking you for one person, and you will not be able to provide that. On the other hand, I can provide you with plenty of coons that have supported or worked or are currently working for Donald Trump. Candace Owens, coon. Ben Carson, coon. Jim Brown, coon. Diamond and Silk, coons. Herschel Walker, coon. Tim Scott, coon. Omarosa, coon. Lynn Patton, coon. Paris Denard, coon. I can go on and on and on. Unfortunately, you will not be able to do the same thing. So, since you said, is this any different from being a Democrat Party super coon, JH, I would like you to post one Democratic coon that you can find. And we both know that that's not going to happen. The Republican Party has resorted to lying, cheating, and stealing in an effort to try and win this election, removing post office boxes from street corners, dismantling mail sorting machines, trying to get somebody's signatures in order to disrupt Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. When it doesn't work, they resort to whining, yelling, and screaming like they're whining, yelling, and screaming about 14 seconds. When you're late, because as we all know, if it were Obama trying to turn in signatures 14 seconds late, you'd slam the doors, lock the doors, brick the walls, have the block considered a nuclear waste site, anything to keep the man from turning in his signatures. He's a coon. He's a clown. He's disrupting the regular elections. Kanye released an album called Late Registration, so he's used to it. This is KTM and the Wake Up Report saying, think a little bit. It will do wonders for you.